sad face. They act like I'm not supposed to be here. I'm completely out of place. Somehow there has gotta be a reason. Evenings as I try to think it through, there's a bolt from the blue, and I see a shooting star shining out from all the rest, while the other stars are standing still. He's on a quest. Every night this shooting star darts across a twilight sky, 'cause he knows he doesn't quite fit in, and he's longing to know. I can sort of disappear. When the sun is setting, it's the right time for pretending I'm not here. Sometimes I just stare into the heavens, wondering if the answer is in sight. That's when I see the light of my steadfast shooting star on his way to. With our legs around each other, one in back of the other. And he says, okay, we're gonna do improvisations. And you're on a bobsled, and it's snowing out, and it's cold. Okay, go. Every day for a week, we would try to feel the motion down the hill. Every day for a week we would try to hear the wind rush, feel the chill. And I dug right down to the bottom of my soul to see what I had inside. Yes, I dug right down to the bottom of my soul and I tried. And everyone's going, whoosh, whoosh. I feel the snow. I feel the cold. I feel the air. And Mr. Carp turns to me and says, okay, Milligan, what do you feel? And I said, nothing. I'm feeling nothing. And he said nothing would get a boy transferred. They all felt something, but I felt nothing except the feeling that this was absurd. So I said to myself, hey, it's only the first week. They don't have bobsleds in Springfield, Oregon. Simply more cramps, then we had to be a table, be a sports car, ice cream cone. Mr. Carp, you say very good, except Milligan. Try Milligan all alone. Then a voice from down at the bottom of my soul came up to the top of my head. And a voice from down at the bottom, what am I doing? Where am I in this song? I'm sorry. Let's go back to we were talking about the second week. Can we go back and talk about the second week again? I'm so glad you guys are all here. Thank you so much. I'm glad I messed up. Second week, more advanced, and we had to be a table. We were talking about that. Be a sports car, ice cream cone. Mr. Carp, you would say very good, except Milligan. Try Milligan all alone. So I dug right down to the bottom of my soul to see how an ice cream felt. Yes, I dug right down to the bottom of my soul, and I tried to melt. The kids yelled, nothing! They called me nothing, and Carp allowed it, which really made me a burn. They were so helpful. They called me hopeless, until I really didn't know where else to turn. And Carp kept saying, Milligan, I think you should transfer to military school. You'll never be an actor. Never. Jesus Christ. Went to church, praying, God, help me. Send me guidance. Send me guidance on my knees. Went to church, praying, Lord Almighty, help me feel it. Help me feel it. Pretty please. Came up to the top of my head, and that voice from down at the bottom of my soul, here is what it said. This man is nothing. This course is nothing. If you want something, go find another class. And when you find one, you'll be an actor. And I assure you that's what finally came to pass. 6 months later, I heard that Carp had died, and I dug right down to the bottom of my soul and cried, 'cause I felt nothing. I read all about it, I knew I could do it if someone would let me, if nothing went wrong. It sounded terrific, and I'd seen a few pictures. My friends had all done it, they swore that they had. In a moment of panic when no one was looking, I made a decision. I took out this ad. High school senior needs a teacher, or a particular extracurricular. You'll be my first if you know what I mean. I need a team. I saw it in print, and it suddenly hit me. What if the person who answered was weird, kind of sadistic, or had an infection, or looked like Mrs. Mueller with her makeup all smeared? It was 10:47, the man was coming. 10:48, he stood in the hall, and at 10:49, a voice deep inside me said, shut me up, you might get lucky. There were 194. I answered every letter like
board. Make you proud of your boy. Believe me, bad as I've been, Mom, you're in for a pleasant surprise. I've wasted time. I've wasted me. So say I'm slow for my age, a late bloomer, okay, I agree. One rotten kid, some sun, some pride, and some joy. But I'll get over these lousing up, messing up, screwing up times. You'll see, Mom, now comes the better part. Someone's gonna make good, cross his stupid heart, make good, and finally make you proud of your boy. A louse and a loafer, you won't get a fight here, no ma'am. Say I'm a gold brick, a goof-off, no good, but that couldn't be all that I am. The water flows under the bridge, let it pass, let it go. There's no good reason that you should believe me, not yet, I know. But someday and soon, I'll make you proud of your boy. Though I can't make myself taller or smarter or handsome or wise, well, I'll do my best. What else can I do, since I wasn't born perfect like Dad or you? Mom, I will try hard to make you proud of your boy.
Coming. This is really, really, really exciting. And there's like a lot of people in here. Like a lot of people. Thank you so much. This is exciting. Wow. I had a little piano trouble there. Something fell over or something?
String broke.
String broke? Wow, really? Which string?
Which one? The G string?
The G string? Woo! All right. Okay, I'll try to sing that note whenever we need it. Wow. Oh, wow. Thank you for the Simpsons calendar. Thank you for the flowers. I don't know if you noticed, but I had two accompanists in those four songs. There were two accompanists. There was one who slipped in for one number, for the high school senior number, and his name is Dave Cook. Me at the University of Michigan, and he played a show I put together on my senior year of college. It was very fun, and he was incredible, and it made the whole show work, and we always said we'd do something together again, and I haven't seen him for 5 years until like last week, and he's a big star now. He's the keyboardist for NSYNC. Just did the Latin Grammy Awards this week. And I was just really excited that we have him here playing like two or three songs for me out of his busy NSYNC schedule. And I'm really glad that he's here, so let's hear it for Dave Cook. Yeah. My accompanist for most of the evening is Bill McCauley. Major privilege that he's playing for me and that he's performing with me here tonight. He was on Broadway in Saturday, Sunday, Monday. He replaced Jerry Orbach in Chicago on the national tour. He many things. He has the national record for playing Henry Higgins in My Fair Lady. He's played it like thousands upon thousands of times.
When you feel sad or Your prospects are worse. Your wife is sighing, crying, and your olive tree is dying. Tempts of rain. Can't see the decaying.
I think this is your key.
And creditors weigh on your purse. Your mood and your road are both ugly blue. Ain't that the job? Had nothing on you. I don't forget that when you get to heaven, you'll be blessed. Yes, it's all for the best.
In honey, never grow old, never feel cold, but that's a goal from thin air. That's every town that's shaking down, that's to make mountains of money. They can't take it with them, but what do they care? They get the center of the main cushions on the sea, houses on the street where it's sunny. Summers at the sea, winters warm, free, all the sun, you get the rest. But who is buying for the sun and the sand for? You guessed, it's all for the best. On stage. No, it's great. No, that's fine. It's like it's amazing. So, is anybody here? Odds are good, I would think. From Rhode Island. Are you serious?
Yeah.
Who is it?
Ryan.
You're really from Rhode Island? Oh my gosh, I knew you were coming in. This is Brian O'Neill. Let's talk about Brian O'Neill. Brian O'Neill wrote a book called Acting as a Business, which my dad sent me when I was in college. And I absolutely recommend it if anybody wants to be an actor. Because there are so many books about this. He's reading. So many books, you know, about how to make your pictures, how to make your resumes, all this. His book is the book that tells you exactly how to do it. And I would not have found Jesus Christ Superstar or done anything or be here anything without Brian O'Neill. But let's hear it for Brian O'Neill. Yeah. What in the world, it wasn't even him, right? You're really from Rhode Island?
Oh, yeah.
What part of Rhode Island?
Providence.
All right, well, then this song is for you. I did not plan this. Let me tell you, every state has something its Rotary Club can boast of. Some product that the state produces the most of. Rhode Island is little, but oh my, it has a product anyone would buy. Copper comes from Arizona, peaches come from Georgia, and lobsters come from Maine. The wheat fields are the sweet fields of Nebraska, and Kansas gets bonanzas from the grain. Old whiskey comes from old Kentucky, ain't the country lucky? New Jersey gives us glue. And you come from Rhode Island, and little old Rhode Island is famous for you. Cotton comes from Louisiana, gophers from Montana, and spuds from Idaho. They plow land in the cow land.
Grand Canyons come from Colorado. Gold comes from Nevada. Divorce is also a dude. And you come from Rhode Island. Don't let them ride Rhode Island. It's famous for you. Pencils come from Pennsylvania. Vests from West Virginia. And tents from Tennessee. They know a mink where they grow a mink in Wyoming. Minnesota. Coats come from Dakota, but why should you be blue? Why you come from Rhode Island? We'll sing about Rhode Island and dance it, you enhance it more than Providence, Newport, Narragansett. Rhode Island's famous for you. I've been feeling very strange. Either something's in the air or else a change is happening in me. I think I know the cause. I hope I know the cause. From everything I've heard, there's only one cause it can be. Love, I hear, makes you sigh a lot. Also, love, I hear, leaves you weak. Love, I hear, makes you blush and turns you ashen. You try to speak with passion and squeak. I hear, love, they say, makes you pine away. But you pine away with an idiotic grin. I pine, I blush, I squeak, I squawk. Today I woke too weak to walk. What's love I hear, I feel, I fear, I miss. See what I mean? I hum a lot too. I'm dazed and pale, I'm sick, I'm sore. Never felt so well before. What's love I hear, I feel, I fear, I know. If I shout, forgive me if I crow. I've only just found out, and well, I thought you ought to know. James Mitchell is here?
Yeah.
Where?
Over here?
Hello, hello, hello. James Mitchell is big hero fan. He's one of the best Broadway dancers. He was the original Jim Curley in the movie of Oklahoma. And he was in everything. He was in everything. Bloomer Girl. I was there, right? Everything, and he's in All My Children, and he has just worked. He's danced and acted and has worked and worked away. And if I can work as much as James Mitchell, that'd be amazing. That'd be wonderful. Let's hear it for James Mitchell. Thank you. 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 A couple things, actually. Initially, I had one announcement to make, now I have two announcements. I'll make, well, one of the announcements is that
I'm doing, I got a cast in a reading of a musical called St. George. Dragon Slayer, I'm not sure which title they're going with. But a Canadian cast did it in Canada, and then, in Canada, that's how you expect it, right? And, I'm doing a reading of it next Saturday for the National Alliance Musical Theater. I might go open to the public, but I'm not positive about that. It's got the Marriott Marquis. I don't know if it's actually in the theater, I think it might be in a ballroom. But, they do new musicals for Broadway producers, and I think actually this already has backing, so it'll go to Broadway next year, hopefully. And with an all-American cast, and I'm one of the five Americans that they cast to beef up the sound of the Canadian. You heard people at the National Alliance Musical Theater next Saturday, and if it's open to the public, come down there and see that. It'll be fun. The big announcement of what I'm doing next is that I'm doing a movie. Film agent for like 3 years to send me out for movies, and he wasn't sending me out, so he was kind of useless as a film agent, but he sent me out, and I said, I have to get this job or he'll never send me out again, because I'm not going to wait another 3 years, and I got it, and I'm very excited. It's called Internet Stories, and it's going to start rehearsals next month and shoot next month into November, and it's pre-sold, it's an independent film, but it is pre-sold to distributors, so in certain markets, so I guess one of those is New York, because everything plays here. I would think. So look for that. It's called Internet Stories. Very exciting. I have to thank the internet for making this whole show possible. Can we hear it for the internet? Yeah. Glasses I wear when I'm on the internet. I need reading glasses. So they're on the internet. Oh, I am sweating so much. They're fogging up already. The internet. So I'm going to sing a song, but can somebody have a napkin? This is like fogged up. Thank you. Someone has a napkin. I'm gonna sing a song about the internet called the Internet Love Song. And it was written by Rick Crom. Is he here? JCS1D/Heaven on Their Mind. Teeny113. Zero Babe and Seth0785. Just help me coordinate this whole thing all at AOL.com. And back to Rick Crom. Rick Crom wrote this song I'm about to sing. Let's hear it for the Teeny 130. Rick Crom is amazing. He was in Broadway in The Goodbye Girl, which I love. So I'm going to sing a song. I met my love in a very odd way. From a distance, we connected. She was in her own world. I was in mine. It was all so unexpected. I'm only done, the computer was on, so I thought, hey, go online.
Welcome.
I could chat with someone lovely. Then on my screen, appeared an instant message from the girl who would soon be my one and only. So I typed HTTP / night, making love through the computer. Though I had no clue what she looked like at all, I was sure there was no one cuter. We arranged to meet on a busy street by the Newport Center Mall. An evening of excitement was expected, but my bus broke down. By the time I got to Newport, she had gone away feeling so rejected. And I typed HTTP, /// I'm sorry.
I'm so sorry.
HTTP. I hoped my sad excuse would be
Then
I learned my cyber lover changed her email address, and my every message came back unreceived. I'm typing http://, where are you?
I never felt love to change.
you have a drum and
color?
And heard him, oh, beg your pardon. Suddenly I saw polka dots and moonbeams all around the pug-nosed dream. The music started and was I the perplexed one. I held my breath and said, may I have the next one? In my frightened arms, polka dots and moonbeams sparkled on the pug-nosed dream. There were questions in the eyes of other dancers as we floated over the floor. There were questions, but my heart knew all the answers, and perhaps a few things more. Now in a cottage built of lilacs and laughter, I know the meaning of the words ever after, and I'll always see polka dots and moonbeams when I kiss the pug-nosed dream.
Sean Moninger. Let's hear it for Sean. Yeah. And our bartender, Julie. Let's hear it for Julie. Yeah. And Colette, if she's still working. How's she doing? Let's hear it for Colette. Wait for her. and Rick Crom again. Ryan O'Neill. Come on. And James Mitchell. And Bill McCauley. And Dave Crooks. And Tom Tucker. And everyone else I left out. Thank you all for coming. This was fun. And don't be a leaf if you can be a tree. Don't be a raindrop if you can be the sea. Cause a leaf may fall, but the tree remains. It may never rain at all, but the sea remains. Better to be the tree and the sea. See? Don't be the cloud if you can be the sky. Don't be a feather if be the bird and fly. Clouds roll by but the sky rolls on, and a bird can fly with a feather gone. Be the bird in the sky and the tree and the deep blue sea. Don't be anything less than everything you can be. Don't be the sail if you can be the boat. Don't be the lining if you can be the coat. Though you lose it, sail a boat will float. A coat without a lining is still a coat. Meant to be the boat and the coat. Quote, don't be the stick if you can be the drum. Don't be the sugar, beat a plum by gum. You will break a stick, but the drum will beat. Without a sugar coat, plums are good to eat. Better to be the drum, the plum, the coat, and the boat, and the bird, and the sky, and the tree. And the deep blue sea. Don't be anything less than everything you can be. Don't be the moo if you can be the cow. Don't be the furrow if you can be the plow. Cause you can't get milk from a moo, no way. And the furrow's in the rut, but the plow's okay. Better to be the cow and the plow. Now, don't be the sting if you can be the bee. Don't be a two if you can be a three. The sting can't make you a honey bun. Take two from three and it's stuck out one. Better to be the three and the bee and the cow and the plow and the drum and the plum. Coco, perm, sky, tree, and the deep blue sea. Anything less than everything you can be. Don't be the string if you can be the kite. Don't be the darkness if you can be the light. Though you lose its string, you can fly a kite. But would anybody here fly a kite at night? Then to be the kite and the light. Right. Don't be the tail if you can be the dog. Don't be the bump if you can be the log. You can wag its tail, but it can't wag you. Bump without a log isn't much to be. Then to be the dog. And the drum and the plum and the coat and the boat and the bird and the sky and the tree and the deep blue sea. Don't be anything less than everything you can be.
Thank you.
solve the problems of your heart. Well, it all might be a lesson for the hasty heart to know. Maybe living's not the only way to go.
People reach new understandings all the time. They take a second look, maybe change their mind. People reach new understandings every day. Tell me not to reach, and I'll go away. Did the morning come too early? Does a tear of hesitation fall on everything you touch? Well, it might just be a lesson for the hasty heart to know. Maybe leaving's not the only way to go.
And a heart without a home is such a lonesome road to hoe. Maybe leaving's not the only way.
So wonderful. I'm so proud of you.